Now we're going to have our Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. You may be seated. Now we're going to have our Star Spangled Banner. My name is Sajay, and I will be the mistress of ceremony for today. And I just want to say, class of 2017, we really made it. And I'm proud of every single one of you. Now we will have our welcoming by Ms. Morelli Gibson, our class president.
Today is our first day of becoming adults. 4 years ago, in September of 2013, we all were strangers and stood with the people we knew until our junior year. Our junior year was when we all began to interact with one another as a whole. Being in charge of our class shirts and getting them made and planning our events in our previous years is what helped me to get to know every single one of you, even though it was a hassle. But that didn't stop me from doing my part as class president our senior year. It is the end of our high school career, but that's the start to a new beginning. No matter how much we might want to choke and slam each other, we always came together when things needed to get done. We came a long way since the beginning, but that doesn't necessarily mean it has to end. Shall we all become successful in life and want to do what we plan to do? And I love you all, and thank you for the journey. that you guys have taken me on, and I wish you all the best in life.
Thank you, Morelli, for the wonderful words.
Now we're going to have our valedictorian, Miss Julie Pham.
It wasn't the time. Excuse my voice, but good morning, board members, students, staff, family, and friends. I would like to say congratulations to my fellow classmates of 2017. After 4 years of putting up with all the stuff that's been going on, we made it out alive. I remember when I first entered high school, I barely knew anyone, and honestly, I wanted to transfer out. But I'm glad I didn't, because I made some pretty long-lasting friendships that I consider to be family. Of course, there were times where all we wanted to do was strangle each other, but we all, for the most of it, have made it out in one piece. Remember when we would all wait until the very last minute to start the homework that was assigned to us the night before? Remember staying up late nights just to try and finish any projects that we had so that we can turn it in the next day? Mr. Huntley's essay. Well, look, that's all over now. Just kidding. Wait until your fall semester of college, then your cycle starts all over. Just this time, it will be a bit different. This time, you may not have your go-to person to call when you need help, or if you're when you need the answers. We probably will, since almost everyone is going to Rutgers Camden, right? And RCGC and Rowan. Going off to college means we are starting a whole new journey, and some of the people you depended on may be traveling down a different road than you are. Now is the time to test the waters and see what's really out there, and if for any reason you just so happen to get stuck, Thomas was a lifeguard for a summer, so just give him a call. Thomas, can you raise your hand so they know who to call? Where is he? Oh. Walt Disney once said, it's fun to do the impossible, for nothing is impossible if you are determined to find a way to achieve it, and I hope that we all continue to do what others will consider to be impossible. But to wrap this all up, I wouldn't be the leader I am today without my parents, friends, teachers, Chowhound, vets in training, and those who didn't believe that I would actually be able to graduate because I'm a student from Camden. Thank you all for the love and support that you have given to the students sitting up here today, and know that because of that love and support, we are able to sit up here today to end this chapter of our lives. To the class of 2017, I won't miss you guys because we're all basically going to Rutgers Camden. So I'll see you guys in the fall. As for the ones who aren't going to Rutgers, Rowan, or RCGC, I wish you guys the best with the path that you guys are heading down. Have fun in college and continue to be you. Thank you.
Thank you, Julie, for your words. Now we have remarks by Mr. Superintendent, Mr. Bonhanford, and Ms. Martha Wilson, the board president.
Thank you so much. Good morning, everybody. Class of 2017, we are so proud of you.
Thank you.
Let me begin by thanking, acknowledging, and honoring the principal of this great school, Ms. Garen. She has worked incredibly hard to create a student-centered experience, a school that is responsive to what the students are asking. And certainly she has set the bar very high, and at the same time, it's what's very important to her, and something that strikes me every time I visit, is to bring joy to this school, to bring joy to learning. And certainly that goes for the staff here as well, and I just want to thank you. To the students, I just have three very quick things I'm going to say before I pass the mic over. The first is, I want you all to think about the adults in this school who have shaped your experience. Because whenever I'm at a high school graduation, I think about my old principal, Mr. Joya, my track coach, Mr. Pruitt, and my English teacher, Mr. Klausner. And what I always think about almost 20 years later is those three and many others had an almost irrational belief and confidence in me. that allowed me to get to and through college and do other things beyond college. And so I want you all certainly to thank them, but to also just keep them in your hearts and to remember what they did to support you. Ultimately, you got yourself here, but you didn't do it by yourself. Secondly, and along the same lines, be thinking about those individuals outside of the school building who supported you, and maybe that's a parent, a grandparent, an aunt, an uncle, a cousin, a sibling, even a friend, whoever it may be. Keep them in your heart and also thank them. And then lastly, so it sounds like a lot of y'all are going to down the street to Rutgers Camden. Some of y'all may be going a little bit further. You'll have so many options in life, and ultimately you'll make those choices on your own. I hope in some shape or form you'll come back to Camden and give back to the city and to help shape this city in the image of yourselves and the type of city you want to see. Because we need wonderful alumni like yourself to be the next mentors, coaches, teachers, superintendents, mayors, and principals in the city. So congratulations, class of 2017. We're so proud of you. And I want to welcome up our board president, Martha Wilson.
Thank you. This morning, I'd just like to say I'm so proud of the parents, the family members, whether it's sisters and brothers, guardians, the community, whoever has been instrumental in putting their arms around these students today to make sure that they have gotten where they are. And to those who have been a part of the Board of Education who has played a part, that's special. That's the one thing about being a teacher, a counselor, when you give back to the students and those who come to Camden to work with our children, you don't leave because we know that they're special and they hold a special part in our hearts. So today, to the graduates, I want to say, as you graduate from high school, receiving your high school diploma, it is a very special accomplishment. You're wonderful examples of what someone can achieve through practice and hard work. You have a lot to be proud of, and we are proud of you as well. As you reflect upon this special day, we hope that you realize that the steps that you have taken to reach this goal will help to shape you and your future. Each challenge you've met has made you stronger, more determined, and more courageous. Although we don't know exactly what the future will hold for each and every one of you, we know that you'll succeed because you're that kind of amazing students that tomorrow's world will need. And remember this, the only ship that does not come in from a storm is leadership. That's who you are.
Thank you, Mr. Rahanford and Ms. Martha Wilson. Now we will have our class song. We've been trying and trying with the sad song, and it came a long way. Are you ready, guys? Thank you. Now we will have Ms. Morelli Gibson, our class president, for the introduction of our speaker.
Dr. Stephanie A. Branch grew up in Morristown, New Jersey. She graduated from Morristown High School. She attended the College of New Jersey, Rowan University, and Harvard University. She received degrees in Bachelor of Science in Education, Master's Degree in Education, and Doctorate in Educational Leadership. Over her years in education, she has developed a number of programs and impacted a number of students. She has experience as a teacher of business at Woodrow Wilson High School, teacher coordinator of business education, NJDOE, vocational specialist for Camden County, vice principal at Bonsell Family School, and an educational consultant. She is passionate about urban education and has a keen understanding of the needs of students and families, as well as a strong managerial background within an instructional setting. A longtime Camden educator, Dr. Branch was founding principal of the Dr. Charles E. Brimm Medical Arts High School in Camden, where she established and nurtured the city's first magnet school, which seeks to encourage teens to pursue a college degree and careers in medicine and the sciences. She later was appointed superintendent of Leap Academy University Charter School in Camden. She was the leader in a school that enrolls approximately 700 students in grades pre-K through 12th and employs approximately 80 teachers and staff. She is a member of the Higher Education Advisory Committee at Rowan University, for which she earned a doctorate. She is an avid reader and loves to read James Patterson novels, as well as riding her motorcycle. Ooh. She is married and has 2 sons and 3 godsons. Please welcome Dr. Stephanie Branch.
Well, good Lord, I've come full circle, haven't I? To the class of 2017, see, I only did this for you. I dressed up for you, okay? So just know this, all right? Alrighty, I'm going to speak very, very briefly because this is your day. And I want you to, all right now, I want you to enjoy your day. So, without further ado, I want to wish good morning to all the distinguished guests, the superintendent, board members, principals, teachers, parents, and above all, the fabulously brilliant class of 2017. Sometimes we have to look back on a few things, such as, am I going to make it 4 years in high school? Am I going to do fabulous things after that? And of course, you know, the answer is going to be yes. You have to be the master of your fate. And knowing that you have to be that is the beginning. You have mastered who you are at this moment in time. But it's not over yet. It's not over, young people. Let me take you back a little bit to the beginning. The beginning of Brimm. So let's start with a very bright, intelligent, African-American man who became a medical doctor. This gentleman did his very best and was his very best in his field. But he wanted to give back to his community, which was Camden, New Jersey. This fine physician was Charles E. Brimm, who, if he were alive, would have been 95 years old. So you stand on the shoulders of greatness, young people. Dr. Brimm wanted to help and to do more, especially for the youth in Camden. So he met with an innovative group of trailblazers, we'll call them, including the superintendent at that time, board members, and Ms. Wilson, you were right there with me every step of the way. They helped plan and create and mold and shape what you now know as the Dr. Charles E. Brimm Medical Arts High School. This became our first advisory board. And from then, we have grown leaps and bounds. Again, this was just the beginning of the high school. That was the easy part. Then came the hard part. Guess what? Sometimes realtors will tell you, location, location, location is very key. So why not place an institution of education in what was called, and probably still is, the Medical Mile, which entailed West Jersey Hospital, Cooper Hospital, and Our Lady of Lourdes. They found a building on that corner, but before that, guess what? We had to have at least 60 students in our first graduating class. And out of those 60 students, we all went to the fourth floor of Our Lady of Lourdes School of Nursing. Now, I'm here to tell you, I was a little younger then. I was a little lighter then, weight-wise. We were not permitted to use the elevator. We walked up 4 flights of stairs every day with book bags, coats, gym attire, you name it. And by the way, we did not have lockers, just so I thought I'd have there to you. But we did it because we did what was right, what was the right thing to do. We persevered. The elevator didn't stop us. We had higher heights and we depended on each other to make it so. Those trailblazers, those 60 young people that were the first graduating class of Brimm, I had those, we had 8, count them, 8 teachers, 1 school nurse, 1 librarian, but they needed someone to lead them. That was little old me. So I'll say this, I went to a meeting, which I wasn't expected to attend, downtown. I had it was summertime, August, hot. So you have your jeans on, your sleeveless shirt. I mean, you're just, hello, here I am. And they said, oh, by the way, congratulations. You are now going to be the leader of it wasn't Brimm then, Medical Arts High School. I'm like, okay. Is there a book? Is there a guide to do this? They handed me, and this is so very nice, it wasn't as nice, all the papers to creating a school in a cardboard box. They said, here you go, create a school. I looked in that box, said a quick prayer, and I said to myself, I have 2 sons. I'm going to create a school that is safe enough I would want my sons to attend. And that's exactly what we did. They were safe. It was a safe environment and still is a safe environment, but one that is always going to be challenging them academically, to push them to their limits. It's okay if you get mad at us. We're still going to push you anyway because you know what? It's love. And it's only going to make you stronger and whatever you pursue, young people. So I took my little cardboard box, my 8 teachers, and here we are. And I'm gonna tell you something. I tell you the history because you have to know that before you can shape who you are, how you can be the masters of your fate. Know that your journey is going to be twists, turns, curves, bumps, and lumps. But I'm going to tell you something. You hang in there, you hold your head up, you keep the faith, you work together, and know that someone always has your back. Each and every one of you, and I'm looking at you, it's almost like when I stood up here my first time, many moons ago. But each and every one of you are unique. You are steadfast, you're tenacious, You're unstoppable. You're going to take all of those things, and I believe each and every one of you will be fabulous in whatever you pursue. And I'm going to be watching, and I'm going to be checking to make sure you are. Because I believe in you and this journey that you're about to embark on, I know that you will set goals for yourself. You will challenge yourself. Make sure that this educational pathway is not your end, but your beginning. If this little skinny kid, well, back in the day, if this little skinny kid from West Philadelphia can make it all the way to Rowan, to Harvard, to get a doctorate degree in education, so can you. Two questions. Will you be the master of your fate? Will you be the captain of your souls? And you know what? I got a little something for you. Listen carefully. Listen very carefully. And English teachers, I know you know this. Out of the night that covers me, black as the pit from pole to pole, I thank whatever God may be for my unconquerable soul. In the fall clutch of circumstance, I have not winced nor cried aloud. Under the bludgeoning of chance, my head bloodied and unbowed. Beyond this place of wrath and tears looms but the horror of the shade, and yet the menace of the years finds and shall find me unafraid. It matters not how straight the gate, how changed with punishment the scroll. I am the master of my fate, and I am the captain of my soul. Ladies and gentlemen of the class of 2017, I thank you for having me come back and say a few words to you, okay? Congratulations, Godspeed, and much success for you.
Thank you, Dr. Stephanie Branch, for your words. Now we have Ms. Hall for the presentation of awards and scholarships.
Good morning, everyone. I just want to tell the class that I'm really gonna miss you. No, I'm not gonna cry. When you walked up, I started crying, but I'm gonna hold myself, because I'm gonna miss all of y'all. All the long talks we had in my office, all the times I had to throw you out. I'm gonna miss all of that. Now I'm gonna call the students for that had awards. And all of y'all said all the time, Ms. Hall, you said my name wrong. That's not my name. The first one is Aja Anderson Ross. LaSalle University Founder Scholarship, $11,000. So all you have to do is just stand. I should have said that in the beginning. Okay, Natalia Castellan, she has the NJEOF grant, $2,500. Women of the Dream Scholarship, $2,100. Ronald McDonald House of Charity Scholarship, $2,000. Federal SEOG grant, $5,920. NJS TAG grant, $12,438. Fairleigh Dickinson University Colonel FSD scholarship, $27,000. Merit scholarship, $30,650. Priority grant, $1,000. Shantae Chambers, Rutgers University, full paid tuition. Kayla Lake scholarship, $500. Camden High School class of 1996 alumni, $200. Hynesia Clayton. Rutgers University, full paid tuition. Camden Schools Foundation scholarship, $2,500. Aleza Aweri, $500. Wise Women Building scholarship, $500. Javante Divine. She has a full paid tuition at Rutgers University. Dylan Estrada, Rutgers University, full paid scholarship. Camden High class of 1996 alumni, $200. The next one is Angelica Fernandez Lopez, Rider University Dean Scholarship, $19,000. Camden Schools Foundation scholarship, $2,500. Morelli Gibson. The International Associate of Lions Club Outstanding Services, $100. She did a lot of community work. She did the most in the whole school. Monique Green, University of Science, Trustee Scholarship and Grants, $33,620. Okay. Alexis Hawkins. She has a full ride to Rutgers University. KLA Scholarship, $500. Delilah Ford Brown Textbook Scholarship, $500. Camden Schools Foundation Scholarships, $2,500. CEA Scholarship, $2,000. Kiora Davis, Henry Davis. Sorry if I said her name wrong. She's going to go to Grand Canyon. That's in Vegas. Nevada, Arizona? Okay. We had just talked about that today, the weather. She's going to get $7,750 a year. Priority grant, $500. Genesis Hernandez. She's going to the University of New Haven. She's going to get the Charger Award, $12,000. Priority grants, $25,000. Monica Hernandez. She's going to Rutgers University. She has a full ride, full paid tuition. Marquis Hill. He's going to Rutgers University. He has a full ride. He has a scholarship from Camden Schools Foundation Scholarship, $2,500. The most workshop full Prince Hall Grand Lodge, $1,500 and $500 for books. And the Battleship of New Jersey, $1,000. Quayana Joseph. St. Vincent Alumni Grant, $1,000. Faculty Scholarship, $6,500. 16,500. First generation grant, 2,000. Nowicki Minority Scholarship, 1,500. SVC out of state grant, 2,000. Need-based grant, 3,500. Federal Pell and SEOG grant, 5,920. And another one for 1,000. William Mann Jr. Camden School Foundation Scholarship, 2,500. Remarkable Graduate, 1,000. Nene Nguyen, Rutgers University, a full ride. Ty Nguyen, Rutgers University, a full ride. Marcelli Peralta, Rutgers University, a full ride. Julie Pham, Rutgers University, full ride. Shaquana Rogers, Remarkable Grad, $1,000. Mary Villa, Rutgers University, full ride. Lakaya Watkins, Rutgers University, full ride. And the Woman's 2001 Scholarship for $1,000. And you can come pick up your money. I just want to say I wish all of y'all the best of luck, and I hope you come back and visit.
Thank you, Ms. Hall, for announcing all awards and scholarships. Now we will have our special presentation from our class presidents, Ms. Chen and Mr. Thomas. I'm sorry, class advisors.
Good morning, everybody. As advisors, it has not been without help. And at this time, we'd like to give out at least two special awards. The first person came from the office and did a lot of work trying to get things together and helped us along the way. I'm waiting on my other class advisor. Again, all of this, I'm going to do Ms. Holmes first. I'm going to do Ms. Wallenberg first. Ms. Wallenberg. Ms. Wallenberg has helped us with everything from decorations. When we needed decorations for homecoming or anything, our seniors were always in her room as the art teacher, and the work has been phenomenal, and there's been so many other things that she's helped do for us. Thank you, Ms. Wallenberg. All right, and the next is, again, I started off with talking about the person in the office. She handled an awful lot of paperwork for us, and also the fact that she helped organize so many different functions for us as well. and help with, again, keeping things together for all the rehearsals and everything. So Ms. Holmes, we thank you all for it. Thank you guys, love y'all. Thank you guys, love you. At this time we'll have Tajay.
Thank you for our special presentations from our class advisors, Ms. Chen and Mr. Thomas. Now what we've been waiting for, the conferring of our diplomas from Ms. Goodman and Mr. Thomas.
Other presentation. Would Dr. Branch please come up? Dr. Branch, on behalf of our wonderful students and our school, our principal, with our greatest appreciation, Dr. Stephanie Branch, we thank you for taking the time to share your words of wisdom, strength, and accomplishments with our graduating class. We recognize your commitment and dedication. You will forever be in our hearts. Presented by Dr. Charles D. Brimm Medical Arts High School, class of 2017.
First person is Julie Pham.
Natalia Rodriguez Castellion.
Hanasia Clayton. Kiara Henry Davis.
Amaya Hayes.
Smith.
Mary of 2017.
At this moment, please turn your tassels from right to left.